stun and heal combo.
Yeah.
So you have to watch your positioning a bit in that lane as the Luna, even the AA.
That combo is vicious, so something obviously Fnatic are going to be wary of, and try not to get the Luna caught out to your too many Sunaco ally creeps. But yes, yeah, Sunaco.
Oh, the bash!
Oh, gets the bash connection, which means that we're going to get the first blood. 3-4-3. We'll pick up the last hit, and Fnatic will strike first.
I don't even know how often I see that anymore, or how I feel like I see it every single game. Someone gets like versus melee, he's good at just controlling the creep wave and denying a bunch. But mid one as well is very strong in this lane. Dendeep maybe leading like a couple CS, but nothing too crazy. Top
lane.
Here we
go. Sunaco, after he goes down in the bottom lane, joins action at the top, which helps with the heal bomb factor a bit. And they try to burst down Mushi. They almost get down that Sand King, but the Shallow Grave is going to be coming out from Artstyle, and we'll keep him alive and well. They look for a second kill on DJ, and they're going to get it. Burrow will cancel that TP, and Navi's come right back into the game now. Two kills their way.
Perfect movement by Sunaco. Dying bottom, then he just moves top and gets like just the perfect win.
And with all these kills coming together, he's going to get a quick level 6. He's going to get a quick track, and Navi's going to be very happy about that one. Fnatic looking to kind of get some momentum back their way here at the bottom lane. They're in pursuit. Can they get to Ira? The Moonlight Shadow does come out from Dendi. Keeps him good for now, but not good enough. Eventually, the chase will be on, and they'll be able to sense him and take him down. Meanwhile, top lane, Sunaco, MVP of the early game right now, in a bit of trouble, but that same Midnight Shadow keeps him alive, but not for Luna. They're going to be able to take her down. It's Navi who get another strike their way. Mid one suddenly shows up in the top lane, and he's in pursuit, and he will be able to get the takedown of Dazzle. It's absolute bloodshed all over this top lane, as they will also find another kill. It's General picking up a double at the end of the day.
And Sunaco denies himself.
Just ridiculous. Oh, ooh, just out of range. I mean, it looked it was good on the AoE, but you have to factor in the extra few steps Mushi will be able to get away from. And now look at them, quick to turn the pace back around. Oh,
Artstyle looks very in trouble here.
He's trying to move on forward, and unfortunately, he walks right into the posse of Fnatic, and they make quick work of him. They're going to look for a possible follow-up, trying to get a hold of General here. He turns the corner towards the side shot, but look who's there to body block him a bit. It's the Ricky. Slashes him in the back. They get the Lucent Beam, slow him down with a smokescreen, and they'll get it done. They take down General.
That actually worked. I didn't think they'd get him because of the cooldown from smokescreen, but that extra duration of stun from the Lucent Beam in conjunction with the Ice Vortex was just enough time to slow him.
In the best case scenario for your Void, you're looking to debut your Chrono by setting up a huge momentum swinging fight, but this one very defensive, and Navi dictating when is going to be used. Ice Blast flies in the first one of the game, going to be connecting on not one, but two there. So Nico needs the Grave to stay alive, but Artstyle doesn't have a Grave for himself, but suddenly a turnaround play. It's General who shows up just in time with a beautiful Burrow Strike, and he secures a mega kill streak for himself. Wonderful play from Navi.
I think that last tick of the Ice Blast was going to tick him out too, but he still had the Shallow Graves, but he's not a stun. He's not a real disable or anything. He's just an AoE damage potential in team fights.
So Fnatic trying to, what looks like possibly be laying a trap for a 12-minute rune jump, but Navi not in the neighborhood, but they end up going into the Navi neighborhood, but they go right into the up ground, or the high ground rather, and Navi are there waiting for him and take him down. Not just one, maybe two as they make the jump for the Ricky. The Ricky, though, able to make his own jump over to his ally.
Definitely.
Okay, now Fnatic, though, we have to look their way now that we know that Navi have pretty much everything they can ask for at this point in the game. What are Fnatic going to do? And the first thing they want to do is make a jump to the bottom lane, but a Burrow sidesteps and avoids the Ice Blast. But look who sneaks in from behind. It's the little dirty Dit-Yara moving in and popping off the Searing Arrows. Gets the one swift kill. Ohio shows up, drops down the Chrono. It is going to be on the two. Can they get the finish for General? Oh, a Shallow Grave is going to be there and keeps him alive. Can he make it away and create the space? Does get a Burrow off for Mushi. Can they help finish him off? They can. Dendi steps in with a Starstorm and will get it done and gets the follow-up kill. Navi looking to completely take over this game number one of best of three series. Finishes with Dit-Yara getting a killing spree. And we're not done yet. Sunaco gets another one.
Oh, and they're going
to take
it
down. It's going to be a five-man wipe with a track to sprinkle on top of this beautiful and delicious Navi cake. He does make a Valiant jump over, but it's not going to be good enough. Dendi gets that one. He gets a killing spree, and Navi are up, up, and above at 14-6.
Woo! Four or five track kills there. But
oh, man.
Nobody dies on the side of Navi.
Back into their own grind of farm. We'll have to wait to see what the next peaking moment's going to be, as we see Dendi already has his Agnums complete, so his farm potential is just going to grow tremendously here. But looks like Navi are going to be sending in some reinforcements, because Fnatic, hello, how you doing? So Nico might be tanking the gank on this one, and it looks like he will. Are Navi going to consider a counterplay? They already have a TP in. They're going to cancel it. So Fnatic will be graced with one nice little Bounty Hunter pick, but they're not done, actually. They're making a move on in. They saw Dendi leap into the woods, and they will not catch her in time. That Eclipse Beam, I thought was a Lucent Beam at first, is not going to be able to cancel it. Meanwhile, on the other side, another bring-in as they take down the following art style support. Oh, look at this. Ohio intercepts and catches General and Ditya-Ra trying to come to the bottom lane. General's going to be in trouble here. They pit. Bit of a trade. Tricks of the Trade comes out from 343, and Midwan just kind of stepping in with a slide of the fist, but they both get hit up with a track, and they get on back. They are going to be spotted, though. General in pursuit goes for the burrow, and they will get the quick assassination, taking out Captain 343 on the back lines. Are they done there, though? Man, look at all the damage that Dig is able to pump out, but look at the counterplay. Three-man Chrono, sleight of fist, but no real damage. Follow-up is going to be there by Fnatic. But now moving in is going to be Mushi with the Eclipse, and he's going to be able to blow up Sonico. General follows up, though, with a huge Epi himself, and they're going to get the cleanup of Mushi. Meanwhile, they move back over. Midwan orchid it up. He gets a kill, but he will lose his own life for it. Na'Vi still getting out the better end of this fight, and with a follow-up that looks like could be happening here on the Tier 2.
Yep, decent though for Fnatic. They blow there.
And they allow 343 to make a nice little jump to the high ground. General says, no, you're not going anywhere. Jumps in with a burrow strike, but they still won't get the finish yet. Meanwhile, over, DJ gonna get hit with a track. Turnaround Eclipse. A lot of damage for Ditya. Grave, but a beautiful follow-up. Chrono comes up from Ohio to lock him in place, but the turnaround play from General. Oh, what an epicenter right into the heart of Fnatic, and does force him back. No one to go down except for 343, but there's going to be the follow-up takedown of the AA. Can they get Mushi? Dendi wants him. Old rivals of Dota going toe-to-toe, and it's going to be Dendi who gets the last shot in the ass right there and takes him down. Na'Vi with a 1-for-3 trade, and now they can securely move back and take some objectives. Ohio, though, still in lane farming.
Gets it for Dendi, though, so he's actually enormous. Yes. His damage potential, his
damage
burst. Slide
of fist, Age of Steel. Do we believe? He went for it, but it was a bit early. Okay, Ohio says, I'm here now, boys.
Oh,
what
no.
are you going to do, Ohio?
Ohio?
Oh, no. Oh, no. Jumps right in, eats the Ethblade, gets hit with a Star Storm. Ah, he was there. He was feeling it. He went in, but it was too late. And then at that point, he was already committed, and it was just unfortunately too awkward.
Yeah. Awkward would definitely be the word to use.
Oh, no. Now there is no Chronosphere to worry about here if you're Na'Vi. You have an Aegis. You have an extra life. Let's take a Tier 2, and let's try to do some work inside the base.
Oh.
What's happening? Fnatic falling apart. Trying to go for a TP, didn't make it out.
No!
Jumps right into the support, which leads to a double stun in general. A victory epi, it feels like, right on top of it. No, things crumbling apart for Fnatic here on the back end of game number one. This leads to killers themselves. Smoke through this top lane right now, but they'll
catch
no...
the scan. They do get the Na'Vi heroes scanned up, so they do know they're there. But I don't know if that's the best place for them to really take a fight.
Mushi!
Does he catch the arrow?
Oh, no! Hit him right in the side. It was a T-bone hit. And that is going to be Dendi, godlike, as he finishes off Mushi. Wonderful. Wonderful connection there by Dendi.
When the arrow hits just right.
Mwah! Three, some damage on the racks. Here comes the sleight of fists, the smoke screen, everything Fnatic can pull out to slow down Na'Vi.
Yep. Ditya has a Mithril Hammer, so more than likely the BKB, but still leaving his options
Long
open for the Deso.
Long burrow catches mid-one. On Midwan with the Orchid follow-up. Dendi says, I'll finish it. Jumps right in, hits him with a Starstorm combo, and takes him down. Epi's going to be committed here from General, and that's going to force Fnatic back. General connects with the burrow strike here for Ohio. Can they finish him off before he time walks? Yes, they can. They'll take him down, and Na'Vi might have just put the nail in the coffin, but here comes Mushi back from the dead, back from that arrow connection. Steps in with the Eclipse. BK beat up, but still doesn't have enough firepower to finish anyone off. It's all mitigated between Na'Vi, and it's not going to do enough. Mushi still, though, like a warrior, wants to stand and fight, but ultimately he will fall. He goes down for the second time now, and this looks to be the mid lane rack secured for Na'Vi.
Yeah, it should probably be
Tango noob.
What's a Tango? Perseverance.
Just get the ring.
You gotta get that. You gotta get that one wood so you can buy your perseverance. Though.
There you go. Okay, though. Fnatic, as mentioned, never say die. They look to take a big fight here deep into Na'Vi territory to catch him by surprise if possible. 343 commits him with the smoke, but he falls just as fast as he dishes out that smoke. And now the rest of Fnatic could already be on the desperate lead out, but it's not going to be happening. General's there. Huge epicenter connected. Chrono going to be dropped by Ohio. A valiant one at that, but still not going to be enough. They can't get anyone from Na'Vi down, and they're not going to get anyone. Arcel gets off the grave and stays alive. Fnatic lose four already. Only Midwan is going to be there to survive, but it's not getting any easier for them. Na'Vi continue to claim lives, claim more track money. Fnatic, it's over.
Yeah, it's
over.
Three track kills. Na'Vi's, they just have way too much money. There's no way that Fnatic can take fights at this point. They drafted a late game draft, and it just not playing versus Na'Vi, especially the way that they played this game. It's not possible to make it to that point.
Boom. blasted. And yeah, that GG. Will do it. Fnatic throw in the towel, and Na'Vi will take game number one of this.